Most applications, be it computer or mobile applications, are designed to allow users to log in by typing their credentials, like username and password, so that they can provide personalized services. Identity breaches are very common these days, so securely managing identities may be considered a competitive advantage. In this video, we will try to simplify and understand various concepts that may help to manage identities. Like, what is the difference between authentication and authorization? Multi-factor authentication, single sign-on, federation, and standards like SAML, Oauth, OpenID Connect. Assume that you are developing a new web-based HR application for your organization. The objective is to provide employees the ability to view and update their HR data. Obviously, you do not want one employee to view another employee's data. But you may need HR team to view and edit all employees' data. Let us think about a solution to manage identities and access. First, the application needs to verify whether the users are who they say they are. This process of verifying the identity is called authentication. Once authenticated, you may need to provide appropriate access to the users. The process of providing permission to access a resource is called authorization. There are multiple methods to verify user identity. One method is to verify based on something user know, like passwords and PIN numbers. Second method is to verify user identity based on something they have, like hardware token or a software token. Third method is to verify based on something the user is, like fingerprints or facial recognition. Applications use at least one of these methods to verify user identity. Most applications ask username and password. Authentication based on what you know. To enhance security, you may configure applications to use more than one method or factor for verifying users. For example, you may first verify username and password, then you may also check user identity by asking another factor based on what user have, like a hardware token, or based on what user is, like fingerprint. This process of using multiple factors or methods for authentication is called multi-factor authentication, or MFA. By implementing MFA, you can improve the security of authentication process and reduce the likelihood of a bad actor impersonating the user. Let us go back to our initial task of developing identity management solution for the new HR application. Assume that you decided to implement a solution that asks username and password for authentication. You may create user accounts and passwords for all your employees in a database. Also, you may enforce users to change their password at first login, so that only the employee knows their password. You may also store authorization information within the application. For example, configure a rule to provide edit access if the user is from HR department. Let us see how authentication flow works. First, user accesses HR application using their web browser. The application may present a login screen and prompt user to type their username and password. The application may verify it by checking the information stored in its database. If it matches, the application may check authorization information for the user and may provide appropriate access. It works. However, this is not a secure practice, as User credentials are stored in clear text in a database. You may improve the security by storing the password hash and then encrypting it. Let us focus on a different issue for now. Assume that you need to build another application for payroll. You decided to follow the approach we just discussed to perform authentication and authorization. Now, an employee may need to remember two passwords. As you build more applications, the number of passwords to remember increases. Another issue is the increase in administrative overhead, because application administrator may have to manage multiple accounts for same user for different applications. How to solve the problem? The easiest way is to use a centralized LDAP directory to create and manage user accounts. Any application may be configured to contact the LDAP directory for user authentication. When the user enters the credentials, the application may check in the LDAP directory. If the user is successfully authenticated, then write access may be provided based on authorization information stored within the application. However, user will have to type their username and password each time when they try to log in to different applications. Let us say that we implemented same solution for payroll application for authentication. So the application may have to follow the same process described earlier, like verifying with the LDAP directory and then providing write access for the user in payroll application. Is that possible to avoid typing the same credentials each time when the user tried to log into different applications? Yes, it is possible by configuring single sign-on, SSO. You may need to configure identity provider to implement single sign-on. Identity provider can centrally manage user credentials and may provide authentication as a service. Most of the identity providers works based on claim or token-based model. Let us see how it works in detail. First, you need to configure trust between application and identity provider so that application trusts the claim or token provided by identity provider after successful authentication. Assume that you configure trust between identity provider and HR application. When user try to log into HR application using web browser, it will redirect to identity provider requesting for authentication. Identity provider may provide a login screen to the user where they can type their credentials. You may configure multi-factor authentication to make the process more secure. Once identity provider authenticate the user successfully, it will send a token or claim to the user. The claim may be submitted to the HR application. Application may verify the token and provide appropriate access to the user. User may log into other applications like payroll without typing username and password again, if the application is configured to trust the same identity provider. The access may be provided as long as the user has a valid token or claim. It is important to secure the token by configuring expiration time and by implementing hashing and digital signatures appropriately. These security controls may reduce the risk of bad actors getting access to applications even if they manage to get the token. Let us now focus on a different scenario. Assume that there is a cloud-based ERP application that is used by your employees. When user try to access the application hosted in internet, the application may prompt for user credentials. Users may need a different set of username and passwords because ERP application is hosted outside the organization. The user may type the new credentials. Once user is authenticated, application may provide write access based on the configuration within the application. As use of cloud-based application increases, users may have to remember multiple passwords. Is that possible to use same user credentials provided by the organization to log into cloud-based applications? Yes, it can be achieved by configuring federation. Let us see how federation works by implementing SAML, Secure Assertion Markup Language. SAML is a standard that may be used to exchange authentication and authorization information between identity providers or applications. We will look at a simple SAML flow. First, configure the third-party application in the cloud to trust your identity provider using SAML. When the user tries to access the application using their browser, it may be redirected to your identity provider requesting for authentication. The identity provider may now prompt you to type user credentials. You may configure identity provider to use multi-factor authentication to improve security. SAML assertion will be returned after successful authentication. User may send SAML assertion to ERP application. Application trusts the SAML assertion as it is provided by an identity provider that it trusts. So the user is now successfully authenticated, and the application can now provide write access based on user's authorization. Does this sound similar to the token-based flow we discussed earlier? Yes, it is, and you guessed it right. SAML is a standard that may be used to configure single sign-on for both applications within the organization and third-party applications hosted in internet. And SAML assertion is a form of a token or a claim. So federation helps to solve the problem of having multiple passwords. It also reduces administrator overhead to manage the user accounts on multiple third-party platforms. For example, the administrator can now just disable the account in the identity provider if the user decides to leave the organization. This will disable user access to all other applications, including third-party applications hosted in the cloud. Assume that you are developing a new website for customer engagement, where customer may provide feedback and reviews about your product. You may also want to provide a feature which enable customer to send emails to their email contacts if they find any interesting reviews. How can the application get customer email contacts? One method is to ask customers to provide their email address and password, so that application may use the credentials to log in to customer email address and fetch contact list. But most customers may not be comfortable providing their email credentials, because apart from reading contacts, the application may get access to perform actions like download customer emails and delete contacts. All we need is to provide application read access to customer email contacts. Is there a way just to do that? Yes, if email service provider support Oauth. Oauth is a standard for delegating authorization. Let us see a very common Oauth flow. First, the application has to be configured to trust Oauth server that belongs to email provider. Application may get a client ID and secret after successful registration with Oauth server. Customer may access the application using web browser and initiate the process to request application to read contacts. Application redirect the request to Oauth server. The Oauth server then provides the login screen to the user. The authentication process in itself is outside the scope of Oauth. Let us say that Oauth server authenticate the user somehow. After successful authentication, OAuth server may ask the user for consent to confirm whether user agrees to provide the application access to read email contacts. If the user provides the consent, OAuth server will provide an authorization code to the application via user browser. The application may send the authorization code to OAuth server along with its client ID and secret. Upon successful verification, OAuth server may provide two tokens, access token and refresh token, to the application. Access token may have a lower validity period than refresh token. If application need access after the access token expires, it can provide the refresh token to OAuth server and get another access token without repeating the user authentication steps we discussed. The application may now present the access token to the resource server, that manages access to email contacts in this scenario. The resource server may verify token validity with the OAuth server. Upon successful verification, read access to email contacts may be provided to the application. Application can now read the contacts and provide the contact list to the customer. This may enable customer to send emails related to product review to their email contacts. Customer engagement application may have to first authenticate the customer and then allow access to write product reviews. Creating and managing accounts for all customers can be challenging. Can we avoid it by authenticating customer with their email address? Yes, it is possible if email providers support OpenID Connect. OpenID Connect is another standard that works with OAuth to perform authentication. The flow is similar to the OAuth flow we described earlier. The difference is that OAuth server may now perform authentication and provide the application with one more token called ID token along with access token. The application may present the ID token to get more information about the user after successful authentication. By this method, customer engagement application may leverage OAuth services provided by email provider to authenticate customers. So, you may not have to focus on managing the user accounts. Instead, you may focus on developing features for engaging customers. I hope you understood basic concepts that may help to manage identities.